the project was really based around last year. We had a really good season, and midway through the spring we sort of thought there's opportunities here to maximise yield and grain quality. Can we add to existing applications to improve yield and quality? And so we looked at four timings, GS32, flag leaf, ear half emerged, and grain watery ripe. We looked at solid versus liquid fertiliser and at two different rates. We had two sites in southeast of South Australia, three sites across the Western District, a site at Tamora in New South Wales, and two down in Tasmania in the Midlands. Quite a mixed bag. It really depended what the prior management was in terms of nitrogen on those sites. So at some sites we got some pretty significant yield increases where particularly they were short of nitrogen. At other sites where the nitrogen management had been pretty good, we could make a little bit of difference on grain protein. Probably Tamora was the one site that they suffered a bit with drought up there, and so yield was limited, and basically what we did there was only just put nitrogen on for protein. I think the key take-home messages would be that if you're in a good season and the forecast's looking good, even at GS32 you've still got time to influence yield. Probably what we found is up to growth stage 39 you could still influence yield. If you were looking, if you had a white wheat and you're looking to put quality on for grain protein, then you can go up to as late as half ear or emergence, or probably ear fully emerged, and still make a difference to protein. Try and react to, if growers could try and react to a good season and not have a fixed amount of nitrogen in their mind, if they can, if the season's looking good, the crops are looking good, and there's a good forecast, you've still got time to go and react to it and not miss out on those good years.